Hi dear students, good morning. Welcome back to the another chapter of second PC biology, that is evolution. In the evolution, we are learning how life has been formed before that, how universe has been origin on that, how earth has been origin on the earth, how life has been formed and how it is continued till the human race. Let us see. So universe formed, there was 20 billion years ago, whereas on that earth formed 4.5 billion years ago after so many changes. Once earth has been formed, from the earth life forms 4.0 billion years ago. 1 billion is equal to 1000, so that 4000 million years ago life has been origin on the earth. 4500 million years ago earth has been origin. It seems 20,000 million years back universe has been formed according to the Big Bang theory. Apart from the Big Bang theory, there were so many theories are there to explain how life has been origin in the world. According to the NCERT, there was 6 theories have been given. That first one is theory of special creation. This is also called special creation theory. Special creation theory was proposed by Father Serge is a Christian priest. He explained God has made life by his own hands in the heaven. So upon that, life has been continued by the generations of generations. Just like our Indian mythology, there was a God called Brahma. He used to create the life by his own hands. Later, the fate has been given by the Lord Shiva. Right. So, this is what the trust. There is no proof. Mythology is a part of life. It is going on without any proofs. Whereas, if you take a Bible or Quran, in that also, about the life, or is it nothing but the genesis of life, or genesis, formation of life, they were mentioned. Suppose if you take the Bible, in that one chapter, there was mentioned the first man was Adam and the first woman is Eve. From them, entire the world has been generated over the generations. And according to the Indian mythology history, the first man was Manu. The first woman is Shraddha. From that, life has started. All these are only history. We are trusting without any proofs. Just like that. The special creation theory was proposed by Father Serge. He explained life has been formed million years back but created by God himself. Now, second theory is catastrophism. Catastrophism is similar like a Big Bang theory in that Earth has been under the explosion. It was split into the pieces. Again, it was joining. Just like when we throw a stone and when it hits the big stone, it will become a blast. So that earth is also splitting and reunion again. So this catastrophism is proposed by Georges Cuvier. Georges Cuvier is the scientist who proposed the catastrophism. The third theory was there. It is called panspermia theory. Panspermia theory. According to this, the panspermia theory was given by the scientist Richter. Richter is the scientist who proposed the panspermia. According to the Richter postulates, some spores, just like the sperms, who can give the life. Spores are migrated from different continents or different planets to the earth. Then earth started giving life. So that this is also called extraterrestrial theory. Extraterrestrial theory. Theory of spermiation, it is also called spermiation theory. Spermiation theory. I repeat, sperms nothing but spores are migrated to the earth from different planets. Each sperm, one sperm become plant, one sperm become animal, one sperm become fungi, one sperm become algae, one sperm become bacteria. Like that, life has been originally proposed by the Richter, even though it is not familiarized. The fourth theory is abiogenesis theory. Abiogenesis theory. Abiogenesis theory is proposed by team of Aristotle, father of science. Aristotle proposed life has been origin not by living things, by non-living things. So non-living things rise life. Suppose if you see a dried dung, fecal material of the cattle, nothing but cow, buffalo. After a few days, it will become dry. From that, some worms will come out. It doesn't mean that they are taking birth from the dung. No. So, but Aristotle said that the dung has given life for the worms. Another instance I can give you, an unhygienic food stall. So many sweets will be there. Upon them, some bees, flies, house flies like things will be there. It doesn't mean that house fly was born from the sweet. It is using that as a food material or medium. But during the dark age of science, Aristotle said that life is not coming from living forms. That's why abiogenesis theory. A means what? Absent. Bio means what? Life. Life is absent means what? They are absolutely non-living forms. Non-living forms. So genesis means what? Formation. So life is formed from non-living forms. It is what the theory. And the fifth one is biogenesis theory. Biogenesis theory proposed by Louis Pasteur. Louis Pasteur. Another scientist is ready. And another scientist is Calangeni. These three scientists together proposed biogenesis theory. Biogenesis theory means what? Living things can form from living things. Means it is a contrast to the abiogenesis theory. Also, Louis Pasteur team proved living organisms do not come from non-living things by swan neck experiment. Let us see how biogenesis theory disproved abiogenesis theory, that is also called spontaneous generation. Abiogenesis theory is also called spontaneous generation. So theory of spontaneous generation is also known as abiogenesis theory. Abiogenesis theory was disproved by biogenesis theory conducted by the Louis Pasteur, Calangeni and Reddy. Experiment is called swan neck experiment. The theory of origin of life was proposed by Oparin and Halden, two different scientists. According to this theory, life has formed from chemicals. Means, millions of years back, almost 4000 million years back, the earth has been origin from so many marked changes. Before that, earth was a burning splinter. Just like today's sun, it fumes, it emits so many gases, just like methane, helium, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, and water vapor. Water was not there because due to the high light, what was that? High temperature. And UV rays, ultraviolet rays present, and all these gases, evolution process has been begun, there was no doubt. So, as all these gases are releasing, on surface of the environment, there all these gases converted into water and return to the earth. So that the burning splinter become cold, so that the earth has been cold. the cold as has gone. Upon that, the first substance is water. There was no doubt. First substance formed on the earth is water. This water is called biological soup. Biological soup. This is also called prebiotic soup. Prebiotic soup. That's why most of the journals said that life has been origin under the water. Yes. But apart from that, in the oceans, due to the thermal vents, life has been origin is another statement. But according to NCERT, it wasn't considered. So prebiotic soup, that was the water. What exactly this water consists of? This water consists, first it was considered both smaller inorganic chemicals. Smaller inorganic chemicals, nothing but H2O, ammonia, methane and carbon dioxide. Like, from all the smaller inorganic chemicals, large are from the smaller inorganic chemicals, large inorganic, sorry, organic compounds have formed. So just like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, nucleic acids. Intermediately, some amino acids are formed, some monosaccharides are formed, and all these are present, carbohydrates, proteins, fats, nucleic acids, all these are present in the aqueous conditions. That's why the water is called prebiotic soup. So, this prebiotic soup consists of preservatives, microspheres. What are preservatives? Preservatives, nothing but carbohydrates and proteins together called preservatives. Microspheres means what? Fatty globules. Fatty globules. So, preservatives, microspheres plus self-replicating particles are also found. Self-replicating particles, just like RNA. Here, stress word is RNA. First genetic material is RNA. From that RNA, due to some changes, DNA has been formed. RNA is the least stable, DNA is the most stable. That's why in the evolution, it's participated so actively. So, this RNA and preservatives and microspheres together given first life. It is nothing but cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria is the first living form. So this living form has given a lot of variations in the prokaryotes, the eukaryotes, in prokaryotes, so many changes like protista, fungi, next algae, plantae, kingdom animalia, invertebrate, vertebrate. That is a later on change. But first living form is cyanobacteria, belongs to the archibacteria. This cyanobacteria is formed due to the biomolecules like carbohydrates, proteins and fats and RNA. All these biomolecules are present in the water. That's why that water is a prebiotic soup. Inside the prebiotic soup, not directly all these life-providing chemicals are erased. Step by step, gradually some changes happen in the chemical world. That's why it has happened. The water has been formed because of the environmental changes takes place in the early. This is the primary idea about Apagan and Haldane postulate how the first living form has been formed. Not like chemical theory of origin of life before quantum theories, whether it's a special creation or catastrophism or panspermia or abiogenesis and biogenesis, nowhere there was a proof just how the chemical evolution taken place. That's why I can say it is the most familiar theory. So, once the cyanobacteria is formed, what next? Let us see. First life form is cyanobacteria. Blue-green algae is also another consideration. From this, prokaryotic evolution started. prokaryotic evolution. In prokaryotic evolution, there were different types of bacteria. Types of bacteria has origin. This is also simply called world of Monera. Kingdom Monera has been origin. From this, one side, chemosynthetic and photosynthetic bacteria suspected. Photosynthetic bacteria, from the photosynthetic bacteria, autotrophs has been generated. And chemosynthetic bacteria, heterotrophs was started. First evolved bacteria are heterotroph, later autotroph. Just in the parallelly, aerobic bacteria and anaerobic bacteria is also evolved. From the autotroph, one line protists are started. Protists has been started. It is a different phylum. On the other line, algae started. Clear? From the algae, plants, just like bryophytes, bryophytes to pteridophytes, pteridophytes to spermatophytes. Spermatophytes means seed providing plants. In that, gymnosperms plus angiosperms comes. This is how the kingdom has evolved. Parallelly, from the protist, there was poriferance started. Poriference, nothing but sponges. Next, Coelenteriata, Pinophora, Platyhelminthes, Ascaelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, and Hemichordata. So from Porifera to Echinodermata, there is an invertebrata. Hemichordata is the intermediate. Hemichordata to Chordata. From the Chordata, Physis. Next, Amphibians. Next, Reptiles. Next, Apes. Next, Mammals. In the mammals, primates. In the primate, human. So this is how today we are there on the world. All this is because of precursor chemical evolution. If there is no life form like cyanobacteria, today we were not here in the world. So that's why chemical evolution theory is most familiar theory. If you observe in this rough phylogenetic tree, you can see this is the Monera, kingdom 1. This is the Protista, kingdom 2. This is the Plantae, kingdom 4. The kingdom 3, Fungi. Kingdom 3. So kingdom 4, Plantae, and kingdom 5, Animalia. So all animal kingdoms and all living world has been origin because of the first living form, that is cyanobacteria. So this is, do you ask me, if you ask me that, do this have proof? Yes. Later years of the chemical theory of origin of life, there was a scientist, two scientists, Stanley and Miller, conducted a laboratory experiment that emphasized the chemical evolution theory is the most prompt about the origin of life. Guys, chemical evolution theory more or less accepted. Stanley Miller's experiment has been proven, there is no doubt, with some entities. Let us recap them. The Stanley Miller's experiment is conducted in the year of 1953. In some books and journals, generally 1952 has been mentioned. They were started, but experiment has been completed and published in the 1953. Now, conducted by Stanley Miller. Stanley Miller is the main scientist who established the equipment, structure and formula. Later, it was supervised by another scientist, Howard Urey. So that is why it is also called a Urey experiment. Miller and a Urey experiment is also right word. Stanley Miller is one scientist and Howard Urey is another scientist. That's why it is Miller-Urey experiment. Together is also called Miller-Urey experiment. One is a conductor, another one is observer. Next one. Location of this experiment. When does the first experiment has conducted? Means University of Chicago. Now, what are the established entities in this experiment? Means temperature that is used at 800 degrees Celsius in the boiler chamber. Gases mixture along with the water, three gases has been used in the first experiment. In the next experiment, they were changed. So, methane in the two molecules and hydrogen, two molecules, and ammonia, one molecule. So, the given ratio is 2:2:1 ratio. Is the methane and hydrogen and ammonia respectively. Next, lightning effect given by the electrode is about 70,000 millivolts. Then amino acids are identified by PC. Generally, amino acids are identified are three. They are alanine, glycine, and aspartic acid, also called aspartate. But PC means what? Paper chromatography. Paper chromatography. By using paper chromatography, Miller observed five different types of amino acids. The first one is glycine. Second one is alpha alanine. Third one is beta alanine. And fourth one is aspartate or aspartic acid. Aspartic acid also considered as aspartate. Then final one is AABA, means alpha aminobutyric acid. Short form is AABA. These five, they are observed in the inference of paper chromatography. But generally in the experiment, they observed only three amino acids. They are glycine, alanine, and aspartic acid. Once the chemical ratio is replaced by any other chemical, amino acids are also changes. Later, the Stanley's students, so many after 1960s and 70s, they conducted by replacing them with other chemicals, and the amino acids gaining is also changed. Even though the experiment has been conducted, about the origin of life, so many suspicions are there. According to the chemical evolution of theory, when does the life and earth has been origin? Let us see. Regarding this Stanley's Miller experiment, one important thing I am going to introduce in the conclusion part, that is, we have no clear idea about how the first self-replicating metabolic capsule of life arose. But this experiment is emphasizing just like methane, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen combinations can produce sugars, glycerol, and fatty acids. These glycerol and fatty acids, according to the Oppenheimer theory, can produce microspheres. Microspheres. Sugar molecules and proteins can produce co-derivatives. Co-derivatives. So, co-derivatives and microspheres together called protobiomes. Protobiomes. Very important. Protobiomes is equal to co-derivatives and microspheres. Microspheres, co-derivatives together form protobiomes. Protobiomes plus self-replicating particle is equal to life. So, methane, hydrogen cyanide, and ammonia, water, these combinations produce purines and pyrimidines. Purines and pyrimidines that can produce RNA. The first genetic material is RNA. Now, these protobiomes and RNA gives first life. This is the idea. Probably it has been origin before 2000 million years back. Okay, not sure. Then, methane, ammonia, carbon dioxide, water combination given amino acids. Amino acids given proteins. So that co-derivatives, nothing but sugars and amino acids. Microspheres, nothing but fats. These fats and co-derivatives forms protobiomes. Protobiomes plus self-replicating particles, RNA. All these are giant, means big molecules. So non-cellular forms of life could have originated in 3 billion years ago by the precursor of life given by the giant molecules like RNA. RNA is a self-replicating particle. RNA is a self-replicating particle. And proteins plus polysaccharides, these two are called co-derivatives. Co-derivatives and fats are called microspheres. Microspheres. So all these are formed in water. That's why water is called prebiotic soup. It was discovered by scientist Haldane. That's why it is also called Haldane soup. Haldane soup consists of life forms that are nothing but self-replicating particles and protobiomes. Protobiomes. I repeat, self-replicating particles and protobiont together called life. From here I will come. Life might have been origin 3 billion years ago by the combination of self-replicating particles and protobionts. What is self-replicating particle? There is no doubt RNA, first genetic material. What are protobionts? Conservatives and microspheres. Conservatives means proteins and polysaccharides. Microspheres means fats, globules. These two are called protobionts. Protobionts along with the self-replicating particle, life. This is how the life might be origin in 3000 million years back or 3 billion years back is the what? Darwinism. Charles Darwin, who is called father of evolution, proposed some postulates that are called Darwinism. Darwinism simply called natural selection. Theory of natural selection, we can call up simply. That is briefly Darwinism. Darwin is a scientist. When he was travel towards Galapagos Island in the South America by a special scientific research ship that is called Beagle. Beagle is the name of the ship in which Darwin traveled to some islands. There he identified some kind of different types of finch birds, nothing but they are called Darwin birds later. This is, we will discuss about the examples for natural selection in the next class. But he studied Malthus books, that is, so Darwin was inspired by a book, Essay on Population, written by the scientist Malthus. And he also studied about the origin of species and all. Finally, he concluded a few things. What are the postulates of the Darwinism is a very important thing. The first one is, every organism has a capacity to reproduce, that is called prodigality. Prodigality. Prodigality means a capacity of reproduction is present. If it is increased as such, then what will happen? Population increase. When population increase, definitely imbalance takes place between the food and place for the nothing but living space and other resources. So that imbalance taken place for food source and space. Food and other resources, nothing but mating as well as for the living space, everything, the competition takes, nothing but imbalance takes place. So population will be increased, source cannot be increased, so the imbalance takes place between the population and resources. That time, struggling will be there, this takes place, that's called struggle for existence. Struggle for existence, to live, to eat, to cope up. So much of competition takes place. That is why struggling. This struggling is maybe intraspecific or interspecific or environmental. What does the three mean? So struggling means what? It is very tough to get the food or space. Why? Because too much of population. That is why if it is the intraspecific, intraspecific means what? Competition or struggling between same species. Interspecific means what? Between. So here, same species. Example, if the two tigers are fighting for the same food, nothing but a deer, then that is called intraspecific. Whereas interspecific means what? Between two different species. Here, suppose so the same deer hunting by tiger as well as lion. Tiger and lion are both two different species because of their forage habits, means their habit of the same eating habits, they are fighting for them. That is why it is called interspecific. But environmental, sometimes due to the floods, due to the natural calamities, some natural calamities. Food and resources will be isolated or reduced. That is also a natural competitor. But compared to the intraspecific, interspecific is less. Why? Because two different species can fight for only food, sometimes shelter. But intraspecific struggling is very hard because the same type of species are fighting for food, reproductive habits, as well nothing but mating, as well as sources, nothing but the state. That is why intraspecific competition is more dangerous. Now, if they are struggling, suppose there were four tigers are there, one tiger is dominating other three, then it will easily get the food. Means that is what survival of fittest. Survival of fittest. If it want to be survive, it has to be fit. Other than that, that is a race of life. So whenever it is survival because of showing its fitness, then it will have food, it will have a space, and it will have all the resources without any problem. But others may be problem who are failed to show their fitness, then they cannot be survived. When they are survived, they will select them. Natural selection techniques. Suppose when giraffes are evolved, natural selection was a good example. Suppose they got a problem to get the food. That time they have stretched their neck towards the heights of the tree. That's why the terminal parts also they use it to catch the food. Because of that, they are selected by nature. If they are not adapted their character, they cannot be seen by us today. So that another thing is when they are adapted characters by natural selection, then the characters will be acquired. Characters will be acquired. Acquired means what? Adopted. They are adopted and the characters will be inherited. The characters will be inherited. Inheriting of acquired characters. Acquired characters. So, prodigality will be there. If the prodigality increases, imbalance takes place between the food and organism. Then struggling takes place. If the struggling are three types, intraspecific, interspecific or environmental. Then one will prove themselves, others will fail. Who fails will be eliminated. Who proven themselves will be survived by their showing fitness. Next, they will be selected by the nature in the race. Next, these characters will be acquired and transferred to the next generation. After inheriting these characters, new species will form. That is called speciation. What is speciation? Formation of new species. Formation of new species. Called speciation. So speciation is the result of natural selection. That's why natural selection is most familiar theory given by the Darwin. So Darwin postulates are simply 8. What is the first one? Prodigality. Second one, population increase so that imbalance takes place for the food and sources for the higher increase the population. Struggle for existence is the result by imbalance of food. That struggle may be intra or inter or environmental, some natural calamities. So because of that, showing fitness, organisms will be survival. This is survival of fitness. Next, natural selection. So nature will select to the nature will select the organisms though have fitness. Though do not have a fitness will be eliminated since. Next, such organisms who are selected by the nature, their characters will be acquired. Successful adaptations will be acquired and transferred to the offsprings through the genes. These inherited characters are acquired. Later, new species will come because of adaptations. That is why it is called speciation. New species will form by acquiring characters is the theme of natural selection. So, natural selection is proposed by Darwinism. Then what is Neo-Darwinism? Let us see. Neo-Darwinism. So, Darwinism is the most popularized evolution theory in which there was one drawback. Darwin explained survival of fittest, but he failed to explain arrival of fittest. How to overcome the problem, he did not explain. The one who overcome the problem will be selected by the nature was kept under the natural selection. But the one who failed, how to overcome the problem, he doesn't explain. Means he explains survival of fittest, but not arrival of fittest. So that after some allegations, Darwin again proposed a new theory along with the natural selection, that is gene variability. So means neo-Darwinism, means updated Darwin theory, consists of two important aspects. Number one is natural selection, already proposed in the Darwinism, and number two is gene variability. What is gene variability? Let us see. Gene variability is an important aspect of neo-Darwinism, which consists of four important aspects. Number one is mutation. What is mutation? Sudden changes occurs in the gene sequences. Already in the molecular basis of inheritance, we have seen some adaptations. Suppose sickle cell anemia, in the hemoglobin amino acid sequences, in the polypeptide, if one amino acid is replaced by another amino acid, then function of RBC will be changed because of its shift. Just like that, if any single gene, it is a point mutation, or entire sequence of gene is replaced or substituted or deleted, whatever it is, then that is called frameshift mutations. Then their normal genotypes will be changed, then their characters also will be changed. So that is how mutations take place in the generations. These mutations are carried out by the offsprings, and few new species will be provided. That is why mutations are very important for the evolution. We can say mutations are driving evolution. Next one is recombinations. During sexual cell division, nothing but meiotic division, so many recombinations take place in the pachytene and zygotene, so that characters are recombinant and random. They are also considered as hybridization. Suppose cell pollination is compared to the very least characteristics of the cross-pollination. Cross-pollination is much better. Means new forms, nothing but hybrid forms are generating due to the variability. Then last one is genetic drift. What is genetic drift? In a small population, due to a sudden change or natural calamity, after that calamity, the rest of organisms creates new species. Suppose there was an island is there. Island means all the sites there was a volcano. Suddenly a tsunami like calamity happened. So when tsunami hits the smaller island, all the population, 99% of people will be died or disabled. But 10% who skipped the calamity are adopting characters after the calamity in this particular geographical area. Means after tsunami, in that geographical area, so many changes will occur. According to that changes, the 10% of remaining people who are not affected by the calamity will show new characters and form speciations. That is called genetic drift. So gene changes occurs in the mutation, gene pool, nothing but genetic sequences changes in the population is called genetic drift. It should be less population or limited population. It is also explained by bottleneck experiment. So genetic drift is explained by bottleneck experiment. It is also called founder's effect. Founder's effect. Bottleneck experiment means if you take a narrow neck bottle, you just fill all the stones. Suddenly you flip it or invert it, all the stones cannot fall down. Very few stones will be fallen down and rest of things will be stuck. So when we invert the bottle, if you assume that inversion of the bottle is a problem or calamity, most of them are arrested, few are escaping. Like that, when calamity comes, few are escaping, they will be survivor as with new characters and forming a new species, they are called founders. I hope you understand that genetic drift concept. So that natural selection and genetic drift, these are two are explained in the neo-Darwinism. As we have discussed the two theories, one is the Darwinism, another one is neo-Darwinism. Let us see, the next one is Lamarckism. Jean Baptiste Lamarck. He studied based on the comparisons between the fossils and living organisms. He proposed some postulates. They are new needs. Whenever organism is developing, then new needs. Whenever the changes occur space in the surroundings or environments, we have to change ourselves. That is called new needs. So these new needs, according to the changes, occurs in surrounding or environment. Fine. So when new needs happening, then such characters will be acquired. Acquired means what? Adopted. Then these characters will be inherited through the somatoplasm. Somatoplasm means cytoplasm. Then they are inherited to the offsprings through all over the. They are inherited to the next generations through offsprings. So then new species are coming. That is called speciation. Example: if you take giraffe neck. Here, when characters are acquired, one important thing is the use and disuse of organs. This is a very, very important postulate in the melanism. What is industrial melanism? Who proposed? Well, it was contributed by scientists and all eugenicists. This industrial melanism experiment has been conducted in different aspects. Who conducted this means Bernard Castelnau is the scientist. In 1850, he was conducted. In 1850, there was a set of urbanization was not there in the England. There was a complete rural where industrial setup was not there that time. He observed, and what he observed and phenomena, everything we will see little later. Now, when he was conducted means in 1920, after industrialization setup completely in the England. So conducted with an organism that simply called moth. That moth scientific name is Bistrom butularia. So Bistrom butularia is the common name. But the common name is moth. In the Melanesia and purple, there are two different colors is taken. Melanesia is nothing but a dark colored moth, simply gray color or black color, whereas peppered moth is a white color moth. So peppered is white color moth and dark color moth is Melanesia. This is white color. Done. So in 1850, when there was no good setup of industries, when there is no urbanization in the England, if you see the barks of the tree, nothing but the stem surface is very light color, and whereas if it is a bark of a particular tree, then this is light bark. And here lichens were present. What are lichens? Lichens are pollution indicators. Lichens are association of algae and fungi. Where does the lichens are there on the trees? That means there was no pollution. When in the atmosphere, sulfur dioxide and other pollutants are rich, because of that, tree barks will become very dark. And because of the presence of such as sulfur dioxide and all these moths, so these lichens will be dead. Due to the absence of lichens, you can predict that there was a pollution. When lichens were present, there was no pollution. What I am trying to convey here is, so during 1850, I am talking about 1850s, there was no pollution, so that all the barks of the trees are light in color. On the light, there was peppered moths are present not. This peppered moths are present not Melanesia. Why? So because of their color white on the light color, they do not appear, then easily they can prevent or escape from the predators. Suppose if a bird comes, if it is a dark in color, on the white color background, it easily appear to the predators like birds and other carnivores, so that they will catch up from their box, light background, and they become a prey for the predators. So that to escape as a prey, they are continuing the color white on the light color background. The white is easily escapable by the predators. As on technology goes up, and in the England, when 1920 there was a complete urbanization setup has been done because of the industries. A lot of smoke will be released by the industries. There was a lot of pollutants in the gas. The presence of all these gases, the tree barks are becoming black color. So when does the tree bark becomes black color? Black color. So because by the pollutants, the tree bark become black color. Then this white color moths appear very clearly to the predators like birds. They will catch them. So Magnesia moths are formed. So white color become reduced and black color become increased. Whenever the black color is, so because of this dark background, the Melanesia moths, nothing but dark moths, due to the same color, they escape from the predators, whereas the white color peppered moths are easily appear. Then when urbanization takes place, which color of moths are increased? Dark is increased. So but in 1850, which color moths are very common, means white or peppered moths are common to escape from the predators. So the changes occurs in the environment are adapted by the organisms to escape from their prey is a good example for that is acquired characters.